Hello everyone, today we are going to see VI relation for the basic electrical elements. Okay, which are the basic electrical elements? R, L and C. So we are going to write down some equations to relate voltage and current for R, for L and for C. For this subject it is a most important part. Okay, the relationship between voltage and current is the most important part of this chapter, or you can say for this whole syllabus, or you can say for the electrical or electronics engineering. Okay, so one by one we are going to write down equation for voltage, for current in R, in L and in C. Okay, so first I am going to start with the resistance. Okay, so first the resistance R. Everyone, we know that the unit of resistance is R. You also know the symbol of R. Okay, this is the symbol of R. Okay, now I will divide this equation in two part. Okay, both part are as useful. Okay, the one part is the equation in time domain. Okay, and another part in frequency domain. Okay, frequency domain. Time domain, it means these equations are in form of T. Okay, you can see a T, time T in the equation, and in frequency domain you can see the frequency, that is omega watt in the equation. Okay, so first in time domain equation, again I have two parts. One is the voltage across resistance, another is the current through the resistance. Same way in frequency domain, voltage across resistance and current through the resistance. Okay, so very first, what will be the voltage across resistance? We all know that V is equal to I into R. Okay, this will be the first equation. All have to remember these equations, then and then you can solve the example. Second is I, so current through inductor, which is equal to V by R. Okay, another thing, for the frequency domain, the frequency domain for the resistance equations are the same, that is V is equal to IR and I is equal to V by R. Okay, so this is the first, that is voltage and current relationship for the resistance. Okay, the first element, voltage and current equation. Okay, now I am moving towards the another element. Okay, so let's take a inductor. Okay, what is the equation of unit of inductor? The inductor is measured in Henry, and we all know the symbol. Okay, this will be the symbol of inductor. Now first equation for the time domain, time domain voltage across inductor, time domain current through inductor, voltage across inductor frequency domain and current in frequency domain. So we have four equations for the inductor also. Okay, first voltage across inductor in time domain. Okay, remember this equation, V is equal to L into d I of t by dt. Remember this equation, d I of t by dt. Okay, another equation, current through inductor, that is I. We have to write down equation of I. I will give you a hint at the last that how to remember these equations. Okay, so I is equal to 1 upon L integration V of dt. Okay, simple equation. I is equal to 1 upon L integration v of t dt. Okay, in frequency domain, now we are going towards the frequency domain. So whenever we are writing down equation for the inductor in frequency domain, we required the reactance of inductor. Okay, reactance of inductor, that is I required XL. Okay, what is XL? Which is equal to 2 pi FL, or you can see omega L. In hertz, if frequency is given in hertz, that is 2 pi FL. If it is given in radian per second, that is omega L. So I required XL. Okay, now what will be the voltage across inductor? Simple equation, very simple equation. V is equal to I into J XL. Okay, I into J XL. Why we are writing down J? Because it is a reactive term, a reactive quantity. The reactance of the inductance, it is always seen on the imaginary axis. So we are writing here I into J XL. Okay, same way for the voltage. So voltage, a current through inductor, which is equal to again V divided by J XL. V divided by J XL. Okay, simple equation, same as the resistance. Okay, only we have to write down here a reactance of the inductor. Okay, and reactance, again it is a imaginary quantity, that's why we are writing down here JXL. Okay, now the third part, or we can say the third quantity. The third quantity is this is the second. The third quantity is C. Okay, now unit of C, we all know that is Faraday. What is the symbolic representation? So we are here writing down this one. Okay, now again we have two parts, that is one is time domain, another is frequency domain. In time domain, voltage across capacitor 1 upon C integration I of t dt. Okay, same way, current through inductor in the time domain C dv by dt. D, I can write down here as a dv of t by dt. Okay, so this will be the voltage and current for the capacitor in time domain. Again for frequency domain, I required XC. Okay, that is, you know what is XC? It is capacitive reactance. Okay, now capacitive reactance, we all know the equation of capacitive reactance, that is 1 upon omega C. Okay, I am not writing here 1 upon 2 pi FL, because we all know that is omega is equal to 2 pi F. Some things you have to remember. Okay, now in frequency domain, we required again XC. Okay, so in frequency domain, voltage across capacitor is equal to I into minus J XC. Okay, V is equal to I into minus J XC, that is the voltage across capacitor in frequency domain. Okay, and again V by minus J XC. Okay, V by minus J XC, that is the current through the capacitor in frequency domain. Okay, so this table, for the whole chapter or for the whole syllabus, This table is the most important part. This will be the most important part of the syllabus. Okay, if you know, if you remember this equation, you can solve any example very easily. If you have problem to apply this equation, then it is too much difficult. So carefully read out this data. Okay, how to remember? This will be the simple. You can see here the voltage across inductor and current through capacitor. These are the look like same quantity. Okay, Ldi by dt and Cdv by dt. Only you have to remember, that is voltage across inductor. Whenever you are going to write down, going to find out equation of voltage, the another side of sign that always has a I term. Okay, we are finding out what? V. So once in left hand side we have V, so always there will be a right hand side with the I quantity. Okay, so is equal to, before is equal to we have V. So here on the right hand side of is equal to we have I. So voltage across inductor, that is L d I of t by dt. Same for the current. So you can say voltage across current, voltage across inductor and current through capacitor. These are the dual quantity. What is dual quantity? It is look like same. Okay, same way for the capacitor, voltage across capacitor and current through inductor, that is 1 upon C integration I. Always you remember, if you have left hand side a V, right hand side you have to I. You cannot write down I is V is equal to C dV by dt, because both side there will be a V quantity. That is not possible. Okay, so this will be a simple trick to remember, that is L dI by dt. Once you remember any one of this quantity, once you will remember any one of this quantity, another three quantity you can easily remember. Only you have to, suppose I have only one quantity, that is V is equal to L dI by dt. That I only know that voltage across inductor is L dI by dt. So what will be the dual quantity? Current through capacitor. What will be the look like quantity? C dV by dt. Okay, that is the simple thing. Okay, now these two are derivative quantities, so remaining two are the integration quantity, that you have to know. Whenever integration quantity is there, you have to write down 1 upon L or 1 upon C. So once I will remember any one of the quantity, I will remember the four terms. Okay, resistance and frequency domain, these are the same. You can easily remember those things. You only, the problem is to remember this quantity. Okay, so don't mug up, think and make some trick to remember it. Okay, thank you.